Murphy, and I'm delighted to be here with my three sons to introduce you to their mother and my wife, Beth Lindstrom. Beth has had many roles in her career, but to us, the starring role has been and will always be his wife and mother. She's an extraordinary manager, and believe me when I tell you that it takes all of her managerial skills to keep us in line. She organizes us, she schedules us, she counsels us, she consoles us, and she makes sure that our clothes always match. It's a lot of thankless work, but to us, that's what love looks like. Beth has had an accomplished career in public service. But what you see in public is just a glimpse of what we see in private every day. When one of our kids' schools has a project that needs launching, when someone has an elder parent that they need advice on caring for, when a friend's teenager needs some career counseling, or when someone just needs a caring shoulder or a listening ear, Beth gets those calls and she answers them all with compassion and caring and kindness. And to her friends, that's what genuine friendship looks like. What makes Beth stand out is her commitment. She listens, she plans, and she takes action. Beth is not just talk, she is action. And that is what integrity looks like. As delegates, you have an important decision to make. Elizabeth Warren does not reflect our values, and I think one thing we all agree on, and it's time for her to go. So when you consider your choice as to who should become the next United States Senator from Massachusetts, I ask you to keep one thing in mind. The quality of who you select matters above all else. An endearing depth of character, relentless work ethic, a broad range of experience, and integrity. There is one candidate in this field that has all of those attributes. There is only one candidate in this field that can beat Elizabeth Warren in November. There is only one candidate in this field that is deserving of your endorsement to be the next United States Senator from the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. And I am proud to introduce you to her now, Beth Lindstrom.
Before you on this grand stage, and I would not be here today without the tremendous support I have received from my family and many of you who have helped me along the way. Thank you, Dave and Betty, for your kind words, and thank you to my boys and my husband for their love and encouragement. In some ways, I feel like I'm returning to my roots. My grandparents came from Sweden and settled in a triple-decker here in Worcester on Steel Street. My dad grew up in this city on Peacedale Avenue, and my mom grew up right down the road in Sutton on beautiful Lake Manchot, where I spent every summer. So in a lot of ways, Worcester County feels like my home. I am excited and energized by the many familiar faces and old friends I see here today. I have worked side by side with many of you in campaigns from years past, helping to elect Republicans in Massachusetts. And in nearly every case where we were successful, where we were warned the odds were against us, but we proved the naysayers wrong. Now another opportunity is upon us, and it is only with your help and support that I intend to win the office of United States Senator from Massachusetts. I'm not a professional politician. This is my first time as a candidate. But I will say the same thing to you that I said to Ray Shammy, chairman of the party, when he first hired me 3 decades ago. Give me a chance. You won't be disappointed. I promise to outwork Elizabeth Warren every day and challenge her at every turn. She is an extremist, out of step, and out of touch with the people she's supposed to represent. She likes to portray herself as the only politician looking out for their interests. As always with her, the facts tell a different story. The truth is, she's running for president, and she's doing everything she can to put the spotlight on herself and win the support of the far left. And in a contest between Senator Warren and the rest of the Democrat field over who's more liberal, Massachusetts always loses. Elizabeth Warren supports a large, expansive federal government that tells us what we can and cannot do. Government, in her view, is the cop on the beat that blows the whistle on its own citizens. But during this campaign, who is going to keep an eye on Senator Warren? Who is going to blow the whistle on her? I will. When she puts her political ambitions ahead of the interests of Massachusetts, I will blow the whistle on her. When she attacks the level of despair of small town community banks from being suffocated by overregulation, I will blow the whistle on her. And when she turns her back on our hospitals and universities because she views efforts to finance life-saving medical research as a giveaway to corporations, I will blow the whistle on her. And when she speaks out against tax relief for individuals, families, and small businesses, I will definitely blow the whistle on her. She stated she had done three things in her life: teach, write books, and throw rocks. Well, to get legislation passed, you have to solve problems, and you have to be able to work with others. And no one wants to work with a rock thrower, and I am not a rock thrower. I will contrast her empty failures with my own record of success. As a mom and a wife, as the first female director of the Massachusetts Republican Party, and a small business owner. And in all of those jobs, I've learned a few things. If you invest in relationships instead of demeaning others and looking for headlines, you can find solutions that work for everyone. And it was with this attitude that we were able to cut unnecessary regulations for businesses at Consumer Affairs. And we saved our citizens millions of dollars by laying the groundwork for the introduction of competition to the state's auto insurance market. I will roll up my sleeves and get to work in Washington, too, to make our military strong, to preserve our free enterprise system, to help families keep more of the money they earn, and yes, to secure our borders, including building a wall. You may have noticed Senator Warren goes around the country campaigning for sanctuary cities, as if the rule of law no longer applies. Here is my message to you, Senator Warren. You don't get to decide which laws to follow. Sanctuary cities violates federal law. And Senator Warren, whether you are a professor of law or a maker of laws, you are not above the law. Let there be no misunderstanding. I support legal immigration. It makes our country rich and diverse. Our forebears came to this country from all over the world, but they did so legally. I support our nation's military, and to all our veterans who have sacrificed to make our country that shining beacon of hope in the world, you have our everlasting gratitude. Before we increase spending on anything else, before we create a single new program, we must pledge our total funding to the needs of our veterans. So let's be clear here. This election is about defeating Elizabeth Warren, but it is also about so much more. Too many of our politicians no longer reflect our values. This has become the new normal in today's political debate. It's time for us to find our voice. It's time for us to tell our politicians to stop disrespecting our points of view and start reflecting our values. This is the challenge I'm going to bring to the Democrats in November. And when Senator Warren complains that she's only being criticized because she's a woman, I'll just say, nice try. So I'm out of time, so we need to scroll to the end. So basically, many of you in this hall know me, some of you I'm meeting for the first time. But my 30-year record as a dependable, trustworthy party for this worker, never stepping away, never yielding, those are my Republican credentials. I ask you for your vote. Thank you very much.